Collider fans, apparently a computer can now tell you who is going to die on the upcoming season of Game of Thrones. Dennis and I, we're going to talk about that next. All right, Dennis, this is coming to us from The Wrap. Apparently, Taylor Larkin, a data scientist who works for this Boston-based company called Data Robot, wrote a complex algorithm. This is already beyond my pay grade mentally because I can't deal with algorithms at all. In an attempt to predict which fan favorite character is not going to make it to the end of the final six episodes of Game of Thrones. I mean, we're already mourning the fact that it's only six episodes to wrap this thing up. We know we host a Thrones Talk here on Collider. And so we were intrigued by this news piece. He used an automated machine learning to figure out the remaining cast's fate after studying 2,000 living and dead characters from George R. R. Martin's A Song of Ice and Fire franchise using the wiki that this got connected to. So we analyzed traits like gender, age, nobility status, house, and the mortality rates of families. And he calculated who is most likely to meet their maker based on the previous death. So here are the results. Daenerys Targaryen, she is 83.77% chance of death. Yeah. The mother of dragons. Jaime Lannister right behind her. Tyrion Lannister right behind her. Bran Stark, Cersei, Jon Snow, Euron Greyjoy, Sansa Stark, Arya Stark, and Gendry. I don't want to read all the percentages just yet. I want to hear your reactions first.
I mean, it's funny because you know they're using AI and these algorithms to predict a lot of things. They do this for sports, right?
True.
Upcoming Super Bowl. Who's going to win? You know, sometimes they're right, sometimes they're wrong.
Yeah.
But looking at this, I think he's got his, you know, numbers a little miss.
Yeah. Do you think Danny should be that high?
Danny should not be that high.
Do you think she's going to live?
It's not necessarily.
Okay.
I do think she will die, but I don't think she's the highest probability.
Gotcha.
I think one of Jon Snow or Daenerys are going to eat it.
Wow.
But, I mean, looking at this list, you have Tyrion very high.
Yes.
70%. I don't think he's that high of a chance of dying. I think that I forgot which season it was when he talked about maybe someday I'll just go and live on a farm and make wine and drink wine, you know, and I'll have my own little vineyard or
but
whatever.
That's usually when you die. I can't wait till I get back and this is all over, and that's you usually get a bullet in the head in a war film. So
I think he has a 70% on according
right.
to I think that's a high.
Right.
Daenerys 83%, that's high. Cersei Lannister 60%. I think that's low.
That is low. I was surprised by this.
What are your thoughts?
Yeah, I thought Cersei would be leading the pack.
Me too.
It just seems like the setup is there for her to be killed. She's been riding too high over the last season and a half. Ever since the shame moment, she's been riding too high. Lost her children. I know she's crazy now, but anything could happen at this point, and so she's bound to make a mistake, and her family is turning on her. Her kingdom will eventually turn on her, and then Dany is coming with the dragons. So to me, that all just seems to indicate that Cersei should be higher, but this computer apparently, or this algorithm apparently, thinks, and who knows, the algorithm could be right, because George R. R. Martin likes to swerve when you think he's going to go one direction. He totally swerves another direction and kills people off, so this thing could be right.
Yeah, I mean, for Cersei though, I mean, I thought she was going to die at the end of last season.
Yeah.
So I for me, she's high up there. I mean, Euron, I have.
Oh yeah, Greyjoy. Yeah, Euron.
Only 55%.
Yeah,
54.95. I think he has a high probability of dying as well. I mean, he's a new character, but he hasn't really established himself, you know, as something. Them killing him is not going to be that big a deal. Where you have some more established character, Bran 66. What do you think about that?
Bran, I'm surprised by this too, because the Raven usually lives for a very long time. So to see this idea that Bran could die that quickly is surprising to me. I'll tell you what's surprising. Arya below Sansa. Mm. That's surprising too. I would think Arya was more, because she's the one that has the list. She's the one that's going to put herself more in danger. And I know she's been trained in everything, but she never finished fully the training. So what will that do? How will that play out? And I think Sansa is playing the game way better than she ever did. And so I think she's going to find her way out of this thing. But who is missing from this list? The Night King. He's missing. They're not saying anything about him, are they?
Yeah.
Don't you think he's high percentage?
I mean, there's a lot of people that could be high percentage.
All right.
So
All right, fair. I think he's certainly one to go. One of the first ones is probably going to go at some point down the road in those six episodes of the last season. All right. Well, what do you all think? Does this, look at this, find this article on the Wrap. Let us know what you think. Look at the percentages. Who do you think should be higher, lower, or is this algorithm completely correct? Let us know in the comments section below. Remember to like and share this video on your social media and subscribe to Collider for more news videos just like this.